So Europa is just chugging along and finds itself above and then below the magnetic equator of Jupiter, simply because Jupiter's field is tilted and it's rotating, and so kind of like a top that's going round and round, wobbling. And so the magnetic field that Europa feels swaps every about 5.5 hours, related to about half of Jupiter's rotation period. So there's a little bit showing the magnetic field that Europa feels, and it's swinging back and forth as Jupiter rotates. And so this alternating magnetic field felt at Europa is actually generating a magnetic field in Europa. So something that's a conductor moving through a changing magnetic field generates a magnetic field of its own. So it's not that Europa has an intrinsic magnetic field because of convection deep down, like, say, Earth does, or even Ganymede does. But instead, we think that it has a magnetic field that is flopping back and forth as measured by Galileo because there's a conductor in the shallow subsurface. So what conductor could be in the shallow subsurface of an icy moon? We think that's the sign of liquid water that has enough salts in it to actually conduct electricity. So it's really cool that the magnetospheric physics is what tells us there's probably a motion there. I'm a geologist, so I like to use the sun in geology, but these guys know it. This is an exaggerated view of the tidal flexing of Europa. So why would it have an ocean within? Because as it orbits Jupiter, it's orbiting on a slightly eccentric orbit. This is exaggerated as well. It gets a little closer and a little farther from Jupiter as it orbits. As it gets closer, it's stretched out more, and as it gets farther away, it contracts a bit. It also librates, nods back and forth a bit, as it does, so you can see from Europa, Jupiter's moving in the sky. So this kneading as it orbits around is generating heat from friction. That's what's maintaining the ocean within Europa. If Europa really does have an ocean, as the evidence is pointing to, then this tidal flexing should be about 30 meters, about 100 feet, every time Europa orbits around Jupiter. And that is every 3.5 Earth days, 85 hours. So that's pretty quick that Europa is flexing up and down and generating this heat. The heat would be deposited where the ice is softest, down near the boundary with the ocean. So that's where it's warm. We don't know if there's heat deposited deeper down within Europa. It depends on how warm the interior of Europa is, whether it's deformable. If it's as cold as the moon down there, as our moon, then it's not going to deflect much, deform much, and so it won't generate heat from friction. But if it started out warm and this tidal kneading began, then it'll stay warm from this tidal kneading. And it may even vary over solar system history. So here, again, is the surface close up. Here are some of these ridges. This is high-resolution Galileo data inside lower-resolution, painted with yet still lower-resolution color data. This is a typical ridge or double ridge on Europa. Light's coming from the right. So these ridges kind of travel in pairs, cutting across the surface. You can see generations, probably, of older ridges, some of which seem to ride up the side and find this somehow pushed up the surface as it formed. You can see little ice boulders that rolled off this thing. It's about 2 kilometers wide here, this ridge. We don't really know how they formed, but the model I like the best is that there are cracks that penetrate through the brittle, colder outer part of Europa's ice shell, and then this tidal kneading causes motion back and forth along a fracture. Like rubbing your hands together, that generates heat and warm up.